Hey guys, welcome back. This week we're going to be talking about endings and how important I think they are to stories. I've actually been thinking about this topic for over a year, so I'm pretty excited about doing this one. So let's get started. Start this one off, I want you to do something for me. Think back to when you were a kid and your parents or whoever was telling you a story. What's something that almost always happened each time? The events of the story would wrap up, slow down, and then they would look to you and say the words, "the end." Endings have always been, I think, a fundamental part of story because story is broken up into three parts, right? The beginning, the middle, and the end. And for me, the ending was always one of the most important parts, if not the most important part of the story, because it's what leaves the final impression on whatever you just heard or saw. If the ending is bad, you'll remember the story less fondly, and vice versa. To illustrate this, I'm going to use a bit of a strange example. So, you're watching the Olympics, you're watching a gymnastics routine. They can do all the fancy flips and handsprings or whatever they want, but to get the highest score, they have to stick the landing. They have to end on a high note, right? I think the same is true for storytelling. So why am I talking about all this stuff? Well, I feel like endings have been a little bit neglected recently. It seems like everyone wants their movie series or TV shows to just go on and on and on and on forever. And, you know, yes, there's a pretty obvious reason for that. And I get that. Money's cool. It's nice to have. It lets you do a lot of stuff. But think about it this way. When you're gambling in a poker game or investing in the stock market, you're usually advised to sort of keep an eye on it and get out while you're ahead and not stay in the game too long, you know? But it seems like the networks and studios have forgotten about this when it comes to their properties, or, more likely, they just don't really give a shit and they're willing to let their properties go down in flames as long as they're able to cash their big paychecks. And that really sucks. It's sad to see stories go down in flames just because the people in charge don't want to ever see them end, or sometimes they do try to end them and they do so in a way that makes no sense based on the universe and the events and the characters around. And I have nothing against big franchises or long-running series. It's just I have something against aimlessness in storytelling. You can have a 10-season-long show that's very focused and has a great ending, or you can, you know, do something else and just let it go on until it fades out and dies. And I don't know about you guys, but I'd rather have a series end really strongly and leave me wanting more than to go on longer than I'm interested in and just have me tune out at a certain point. That's why I think the Dark Knight trilogy is the best multi-movie superhero story out there. Christopher Nolan tells his story to completion. In Batman Begins, we see Bruce Wayne's origins as the Batman, his motivation for doing that. In The Dark Knight, we see him being completely broken by his enemy, so much that he has to retire from public life and being a vigilante. And then in The Dark Knight Rises, the final chapter, we see him rise up again and then become a hero and eventually be able to transcend beyond being a vigilante and live a normal life. It follows the three-act structure as a trilogy pretty perfectly, and the Marvel Cinematic Universe would be close to accomplishing this too if the upcoming two-movie War Against Thanos was going to be the final part of the series. But it's not. I wish it was, but it's not, and because of that, I don't think that series can ascend to the same level of greatness as the Dark Knight trilogy can. It's still really amazing and an impressive achievement with tons of great stories within it, but as a whole, I can't consider it a great story because it's just not complete. It doesn't seem like it's going to be anytime soon either. Ultimately, I've come to the conclusion that no story can be truly great without an ending. Because without an ending, it's not really a story, right? But rather just a part of a story. And not every ending has to tie everything up nice and neat in a little bow like Return of the King or Return of the Jedi. This is a perfectly solid ending for a series. And so is this. and they should have been left as the endings to those respective series. Ultimately, I just want to see satisfying stories, and I feel like the most powerful stories are the ones that actually bother to have conclusions. It lets you finish an adventure with the characters and look back on the journey you just took with them. A story to me is kind of like a window into a character's life or world. They existed before they walked by the window, and they'll continue existing after they finish passing it. And afterwards, you move on to the next story, and the characters' lives continue without us. So that's going to be it for me this week. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, please like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week.